Join us for a truly unique camping experience at the Cardamom Tented Camp. Accessible only by riverboat, this is an adventure lover's dream destination. Over 3 days we swim, hike, kayak, zip line, and spot wildlife through the jungle surrounding the camp. You won't want to miss this incredible destination for tourists and locals alike.
Welcome to another episode of Adventure Unlimited. We've made it to our final location.
Sort of. Penultimate, one might say.
With our bags getting carried. Heading off to the boat. And we're off to Cardamom Tented Camp.
Well, thank you.
Top five, like one of your top five things to do in the entire world. Same. Except he's telling a lie.
Yeah. So we made sure we left some beer for the guys. Should I beer Chen Yang?
Why don't you stand up first and then we'll get up.
So this is home sweet home for two nights. Nice little glamping setup.
Ballara's got nothing on this. Outdoor shower, eco-friendly shampoo and shower gel, sink,
sunburn,
typical Bodang, nice comfy bed. I don't know that it's comfy, but it's on the website it was, so I believe them, and the beer drinking balcony. And I didn't film any of the intro because I didn't chat to old mate before if he was cool with it. But they make their own beer from, they've got like Cambodian ibis, and the ibis do something with the rice, and then the rice does something with the beer, and that makes the beer eco-friendly. Is that what you got from that?
They just make the beer out of the rice that they use to... So people poison the rice so the ibis eats it and dies.
What?
But their rice that they make is... Doesn't have the poison, so the ibis can eat it. They lose a lot of rice, but they don't lose ibis, and they make beer out of that rice.
Oh, nice.
I didn't get any of that at all. But I was just pretty happy to tell him that ibis were called bin chickens in Australia, which he didn't know.
He didn't really like, but that's what we call them.
It's just facts. Can't help what they're called. I make the rules. So we've just got it settled in. As hot. It's real hot. For the Cambodians watching Kadao Klang Na. So we're going for a swim.
And drink some beer.
And yeah, maybe one more.
Ready?
Yeah.
I think I booted you.
Right, full front flip. Coming at ya. Almost coming at ya.
Good morning.
From our first morning at Cardamom Tented Camp. Beautiful sleep last night.
Yeah.
Super comfy beds.
Super quiet, except for just the jungle noise.
And we are off for breakfast and our first adventure of the day. We're going to go do a jungle hike and hopefully see some wildlife. Hence the big zoom lens on for the walk today. Hopefully I'm not lugging it around in vain. So the plan is we're gonna get the boat up the river, we do a hike, and then at the end of the hike we jump in a kayak and then we kayak the whole way back to the camp. So it's about an hour. And yeah, it should take about half a day.
Could do an adventure.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
Very excited.
It's not too bad.
No space for him on the motorboat.
It's okay that we can walk in and we will see what we're feeling.
Yeah. All good.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle.
Feeling very local.
Yeah. Feeling very adventurous.
Pablo.
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 Thank you.
So this crater here was made from a US bomb.
The plane just unloading bombs before it landed.
Couldn't land with bombs, so they just dropped them off. They flew over the jungle into the dots, a big green area, and just launched them. So yeah, that's what that massive crater in the ground is. Crazy. Come through a little bit of a swamp. Now we're coming out of the thick jungle. Glad we've got waterproof hiking boots on. There's another crater from a bomb dropped from America. Out of the open grasslands, a bunch of pitcher plants, back into the jungle. Thank God it's hot out there. A lot cooler under here.
Pretty bloody cool.
So made it to the end of the hike pretty much. A few more meters to go and we'll be at the river, and then we jump in the kayaks and we kayak back to camp. Should be pretty sweet.
1 hour kayak and then back for lunch.
Oh yeah.
It's been a good morning. It's
been very good. Got some good photos. Got to see a, I don't know what type of mushroom it is, but see if we can Google it and find it and put it up there. On the way, I've always wanted to see one. I'm pretty stoked with that. Here's our transport.
You can probably untuck your shirt now.
No, what?
I think this looks the future.
Yeah, my pants are a bit low, but here we go.
Here comes our steed.
Thank you.
What are you?
You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
What is this? It's like a butterfly crossed with a dragonfly.
Yeah, there's a type of dragonfly.
It's crazy.
Beautiful. I like that one.
All right. Great timing.
You sit at the front?
Yeah, I sit at the front. The hard worker goes at the back.
Yeah.
What do I need that for? Alright, off we go. Apparently I need help.
Yeah, I need help. Maybe if we get in trouble.
Works for me. So peaceful. She coming down now. Are you no regrets not getting your rain jacket?
No, I'm that wet anyway. sweat.
Tia promises us that there's some rapids coming up, so that should be exciting. It's like one of the coolest experiences.
It's pretty epic.
Like, you don't even really need a paddle because we're going downstream, but we've just put a bit of a gap between us and the others. Massive blue butterfly over there, but just cruising down, beautiful clear river, middle of the jungle, rain coming down. if you ever come to Cambodia, add this place to your list.
100%.
Rain's died off a little bit. It's got to this wicked little section. Butterflies everywhere. Bright red rocks. Absolutely nailed it.
Professional. Next stop, Olympics.
Rapids round two. Oh. Oh, that's shallow. That's the hella steep one. How much don't you mind if we get wet? This would be the steep one. You go first?
We don't want to get stuck. Don't want to get stuck.
We don't mind it being steep, we just don't want to get stuck and break your canoe. That's what I said. You think Shweng?
Just the fact that I told that, but it was still for something. Let me try that way, try first.
Okay. Yeah. Here, go first. That's the one. That looks fun. Oh no, maybe not the line. Maybe that's not the line. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Hard left. Oh,
I think this is the last set of rapids. This is near where we got dropped off. Oh boy, she's shallow. Oh, leaning back. Leaning back. Smooth as butter. This is the best. And the icing on the cake was the two English girls just going through the steepest set of rapids backwards. They tried to turn around and then in the end they were like, ah, this is happening.
They're going backwards.
As gold. Well, it stopped raining. As hot as balls.
It's not too bad.
I can't be bothered taking off my rain jacket. Because there are some more rain clouds on the horizon. But I think this look really suits me.
It's all pretty. I think this look suits me as well. Covers up my massive nose.
Now a little waterfall. Pretty sweet. Yeah, I reckon it looks good, eh? So we found this other little waterfall. Sorry, I'm muffled because my face is covered. But it's like coming out from under the tree. Well, after 90 minutes, we've made it back to home sweet home. So I think I went like full Cambodian today, where like the hotter it gets, the more clothes you wear. Oh my goodness. Are these cool drinks for us?
Yes, oh, I've already got some. Okay.
You are an absolute legend. It was raining when we left, and then I couldn't be bothered taking off my rain jacket. So absolutely cooking like a dim sim. Next adventure of the day, zip lining. All right, my turn.
All right, 1, 2, 3, let's go.
I couldn't.
on a night adventure. We're going to go do some night time boat spotting of animals.
I think that's the technical term.
Technical term. All about technical terms here. Room and we're heading to check out, so this pretty much wraps up our little adventure here at Cardamom Tented Camp.
Yeah, it's been like one of the best few days I reckon that we've had in Cambodia. I feel like we say that a lot, but cannot recommend it enough. And again, it's one of those activities where anyone can come to the country and come and do, get yourself a driver to drop you off at the pickup point and come and check it out for yourself.
Definitely. I recommend 3 nights here, not 2 nights.
Yep.
You can do a lot in 2 nights, which is awesome, but 3 nights, I reckon you can tick off all the activities and that.
Yeah.
And yep. Still have some downtime and relax.
For sure. Only regrets not booking another night, but such is life. They were pretty booked out.
Yeah.
For good reason. Remember, if you did enjoy this video, please hit that like and subscribe button. Plenty more videos from Cambodia coming in the near future.
Hey, right.